I'm Wendy from Rise and Shine, and today we're going to do an arm series, Shannon and I, together.
Let's work it out.
Yep. And if you have some 2-pound weights at home, and I'm serious, nothing more than 2 pounds, you'll be really feeling it if you do. So no big old 5-pounders for this one, or cans of soup, water bottles, whatever you have. Today we're going to start off, or actually we're going to do most of the series kneeling. But if you have knees that don't like kneeling, feel free to do the whole thing standing. You don't need to kneel at all. The benefit of the kneeling is that we're also going to get a lot more ab engagement and glute engagement. So what we want to do is make sure those hips are pushed forward, that tail is in a neutral pelvis, so hip bones are pointing straight up and down, your glutes are squeezing literally down the back of your thighs, and the crown of the head is reaching up to the ceiling. So you can feel that action of the quads and the glutes and the abs before you even start working out. Feel it right now. Do you?
I do.
Yep. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and take the weights into our hands here. We've got one in each, soft little elbow bend. The crown of the head is reaching towards the ceiling. Again, push those glutes forward, get a little squeeze. Inhale, prepare, and exhale. We're just going to do a little half moon here and lower back down. So exhale every time, wrapping those deep abs and lifting up through that pelvic floor. As we do this, the shoulders are staying down. So the arms are just moving freely in that shoulder socket, but the shoulder blades, your stabilizers, are pulling them gently downward. Let's get four more. How about it, Shannon?
Yep.
Let's go three more. Nice. And two. Good. Final one. We're going to stay up here and go ahead and flip our palms over the other way. Again, a soft little elbow bend, thinking about the scapula, those triangles of your shoulder blades, pulling downward towards your hips. Crown of the head is still reaching up, glutes are still pushing forward, and soft little elbow bend comes up, hugging the moon overhead. Exhale. That's it. Wrapping that transversus. Let's get six. Good. And five. Nice. Hang in for four. And three. Keeping those shoulder blades down every time. Two. And last one. Good. Standing right here. Okay, and from here, we finish off. We're gonna turn our palms frontwards. So drawing those shoulder blades down again, we're gonna slightly push forward. Feeling a little pulse here, getting a little heat. That's it. Think about now reaching energy out of those fingertips. You're feeling those elbows drawing slightly down. Shoulder blades are squeezing together. Six and five. Hang in four, three. Keep those glutes squeezing. And last one. Awesome job. We're going to take a little mini break. Let those arms float down. Yeah, rolling the shoulder blades out here. And then we're just going to move on to a bicep curl. So again, hips push forward. Hands are just standing here. We bicep curl up and back down. Exhale up. Inhale, back down. That's it. Exhale up. Inhale, back down. Let's get six. And five. Abs are wrapping the whole time. Four. And nice. Last two, my arms are already shaking. Final one, we're gonna turn the palms over, roll those shoulder blades back, and lifting up to a straight arm raise. That's it, always wrapping those abs. Now right here, we're gonna have that tendency to rock back. Keep pushing those hips forward, keep reaching the crown of the head up towards the ceiling. Nice, all right, and three more, we're gonna add a little bit of glute work here. Two. And last one. Now as we lower those arms, we're going to sit back onto those heels and then raise it back up again, pushing those hips forward. That's it. Lower and lift, reaching the crown of the head to the ceiling, feeling those quads and glutes working. If you're standing, you can just do a little demi squat, a little tiny squat into those glutes. That's it. Let's get six more. Nice. And five. Good. Hang in. Four more. Keep pushing those hips forward. And three. Nice. Last two. And final one. Stay up here with those arms. We're going to bring them out to the side. Keep that chest open. Imagine that those knuckles are holding walls apart. You're pushing them away from you. Draw under into those lats. Pull deep. Good. Lift up to the crown of the head and then bring those arms forward again. Exhale up. Inhale. Return. That's it. Nice. Trying to keep that torso from rocking so we stay right where we are in space without any rocking. Maybe a little trembling, but no rocking back
or a lot.
Let's get four more. Let's get three more. Nice. and tricep press. So the weights fall right behind the head, squeezing those elbows inside. Exhale, press up. Inhale, back down. Exhale, up. Inhale, back down. Let's go 6 more. That's it. 5. Pull those deep abs down. Bottom rib draws down to the hips. Nice. We got 3. And 2. And final one. And then floating those arms back down. Shake it out again. Another little mini break. And I'm going to turn to the side to show you one of my favorite little tricep series. So we're turning to the side. We're just going to hinge forward. So sit bones go out in space. Crown of the head reaches up. And if you're like me, I'm kind of a curvy lumbar girl, so I always have to think about tipping my pelvis down. So let me show you the difference. We don't want this. We want this straight back. There, so take that tail down. So we're holding this. Can you feel that in your hip flexors, glutes, abs are working. Roll those shoulder blades back, and we're going to push those palms up to the ceiling. So it's an exhale up. That's it. Inhale down. Keep reaching those hands away from you. Keep pushing the sit bones back in space. That's it, guys. Hang in there. 6. And 5. 4. And 3. Last 2. Final one. Hold it up here. Shannon doesn't know what's coming. But we're going to do a little bicep curl here. Pull those elbows in. That's it. Pull those palms in. Elbows stay high. That's it. Keep holding those abs in. Hang in there. 6 more. Nice. 4. Keep drawing those abs in. 2. Final one. We hold here. We got more to come. Pulsing those palms inward. Stay there. Inward. Pulsing. Palms just go directly towards each other. Arms are long. Your bottom of your body from your waist down is stable. 4 more. 3 more. 2. And 1. Final move here. We're going to pulse the palms inward and then up. Bring them back down. So it's in, up, back down, and out. In, up, back down, and out. Hang in. In, up, back down, and out. Let's go 4. Out. In, up, back down, and out. 3. In, up, back down, and out. 2. Ah, last one. And we let those arms come down, come into a little stage. Woo! Nice work. Okay, we're going to stretch those arms really quick, so come on to seated position, whatever feels comfortable for you. We're going to take the arms up overhead. Go ahead and lower your left hand behind your back, grabbing that elbow. Good. Deep breath in. If you want a little bit of rotation or flexion, you can lean on over to the side here. And then coming all the way back up, we're going to take that arm across your body, pushing that shoulder away from your ear. Releasing. Good. Now we're going to grab a hold of that right elbow. Let that hand fall behind your body. Little flexion if that feels good to you. Opening that elbow up to the ceiling. Bringing it back up and crossing that hand over the chest, bringing that shoulder away from your ear. Good. Inhale, exhale. And then from here, let's take those hands behind your back. I'm going to see if you can clasp your fingers there. Good. Draw those knuckles down towards the floor. Roll those shoulders back. Good. And then bring chin to chest. Just let that chin fall to your chest. See if you can get those knuckles a little bit further. And then from here, roll that right ear to the right shoulder. You're stretching that trap, your upper trap right here. Good. Roll down in front, chin to chest. Pulling those knuckles down to the floor, feeling that openness. And then continue over, lift your left shoulder, stretching that right trap. That's where I need it today. Ooh, it's talking to me. And then come back down, chin to chest. Keep those knuckles dragging down to the floor. Closing that ribcage now as we bring that chin up. And releasing those fingertips. And we'll just end off with a couple nice deep breaths. So let's take an inhale.